and welcome to Round Robin. I'm your host, Robin McCormick with the City of Hampton. And we have an election right around the corner. So we've brought in our voter registrar to give you all the information you need so that you can go to the polls and make your choice. My guest is Tara Morgan. Welcome.
Thank you.
I always know it's fall and election time when we drag you in here. But this election has a big change for voters. This will be the first time that a photo ID is required at the polls for that vote to count.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you think is going to happen when people get there? Is it a big deal, or is it, you know, kind of a minor bump for folks?
It's a minor bump, I believe. If you come in to vote and you don't have a photo ID, you would just vote a provisional, and they have until Friday at noon to bring in their photo ID. If they do not have a photo ID available, then we will give them a photo ID up until the Friday at noon, and that would still count. Their ballot would still count.
So people can compensate afterward if they have to, but let's get people ready as much as possible. So if you have a photo ID, it's easy. Remember to bring it to the polls.
Right.
Okay.
Exactly.
What kinds of IDs are acceptable, Tara?
DMV photo ID.
Mm-hmm. And that can
your
be
license,
either a driver's license or
just
the DMV-issued one for
yes,
those
ma'am.
Who don't. Okay.
Mm-hmm. They can use a Virginia or state Virginia or university, sorry.
Okay, so if you, like Thomas Nelson, William & Mary, Christopher Newport, HU, any college issued ID.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Anything else? I guess military.
Passport, any government ID is good.
So if you don't have one of those, and I'm trying to think who that might be. That might be someone who's a recent if you're a high school student, you can use your high school ID, right?
Yes.
Phoebus High School, Bethel High School, whatever. So if you're out of school and you're not enrolled in Thomas Nelson, you don't have a driver's license, you might be in that little gap.
Right.
You can go to the DMV and get a DMV ID, or we can come to your office.
Yes, ma'am. And when you come to our office, you have to fill out an application stating you do not have any ID available to you. And so then once you fill out that application, you get your picture taken and you're issued a photo ID.
All right, so that's free?
That's free.
And it's fairly easy?
Yes.
And it's pretty convenient, but we need to tell people where you are because I think people will head to City Hall or head to the courthouse and you're not downtown.
No. We are on 1919 Commerce Drive, Suite 280. It's off of Coliseum Drive. So you just come into our office and
It's kind of like back in the back there, and it's called Pinewood Plaza.
Pinewood Plaza.
The building. You see it from the interstate, actually, better than you can figure out how to get there. But it's back in the back, kind of behind the hotels.
Mm-hmm.
Handicapped accessible, elevator, very nice office. Just and actually centrally located in the city.
Yes.
Kind of right in the middle there, Coliseum area. Mm-hmm. So if you are in that in-between, there might be some older people who don't drive anymore, have let their driver's license lapse, who need a photo ID, and may not be able to get to the DMV with the birth certificate and all the things it requires.
Right.
It is free.
It is.
Free. In
yes.
your office. What are your hours, Tara?
8:30 to 5,
okay.
Monday through Friday. We are open on Saturday, October the 25th, and November the 1st from 9 to 5. So they can come in anytime. We're open those 2 days for absentee voting as well.
Absentee voting, but you can also do the IDs.
Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
Well, since you brought up absentee voting, let's talk about that. I know Virginia is not an early voting state, which is, you know, you hear about so much on the news, but there are lots of reasons people may not be able to get to the polls on Election Day, and they can vote absentee in person in your office. I'm sure it's too late now to get a ballot mailed to you by the time
we air. You have Tuesday, October the 28th is the last day.
Okay. So you can listen to this twice instead.
Right.
And still make it in on
the
wire.
And as long as we have their application by 5:00 on October the 28th, we can mail out their ballot.
Okay.
And it just has to be received in our office by 7 p.m. on election night.
All right. So there is still a little bit of chance of that. But for most people listening to this, they're going to say, I have to be out of town that day. I mean, what are some of the reasons that people can vote absentee?
Disabled, if you are a poll worker, or you can use that. If they're at school away from college, if they're out of town for vacation or business, either one. For the military that are overseas.
So. If you are out of town, even for that day, because of your work schedule, or if you work I get the polls are open for about 12 hours, is it?
It's 6 a.m. to 7 p.m.
6 to 7, so 13 hours. But there are people, firefighters maybe, whose work shift is
actually
that
firefighters,
entire shift.
They can do one as well, emergency personnel.
Right, because police never know.
Right.
Am I going to have time to stop by and vote or not? Mm-hmm. So it's just safer to get that out of the way.
Yes, and if you're traveling for your work, if you work between the hours of 6 a.m. and 7 p.m., you can also do one.
Okay, so that's open to people, and they can come by your office and vote. And you said disabled, but mm-hmm. also, I mean, if somebody pulls up to the curb and really isn't capable of getting out of the car, at the poll, you can help them there, right?
Yes, we do have curbside voting. If they are coming in person for absentee, they could send their representative that's driving them up with their photo ID, and we will come down to their car and vote them. They can also come to the polls, and same thing, on election day. If they want to wait until election day, they can have their representative come in with their ID, and one of the poll workers will bring out.
You know, that's really nice. Mm-hmm. I mean, that curbside service makes it much easier for people for whom walking or getting out of a car is difficult.
Yes, right. And, you know, and some people want to vote on election day and don't want to do the absentee, so that's why that is available at the polls.
It is a thing. It is a big day. And in the states that have the early voting, I always think that's a little weird because election day is election day,
right.
You know? You're part of a movement. You're part of democracy. And when I was in college, I voted absentee because you kind of had to because mm-hmm. I was registered at my home, not my college. But, you know, it's a thing for some people, and I think that's kind of cool.
Right. And there are some states that do not count their absentee unless they have to.
Unless it's going to make that difference.
Right. Right. For Virginia, they they count. They are the absentee precinct. When you see the results coming across the screen on the TV, they are counted during election day, just like any other.
All right. And is there anything else? What's on the ballot this November?
It is the state senate, U.S. Representative, House of Representative, and there is a proposed constitutional
amendment.
Okay, so
U.S. Senate, U.S. Congress, which is going to vary in different parts of
the... Yeah, it's the House of Representatives, yes.
And then there's I didn't realize that. What's
that? It's on the tax and finances, but the information is on our website, which is www.hampton.gov/voter.
Yep.
And so they can find any of that information on there.
And that's also a good thing to remind people as a resource. So if they forget what hours you said you were open, mm-hmm. if they need to Google look at your address and click through to a map to find the office, anything, if you see the list of what is acceptable IDs, any of those things, we'll have those on the website and copies of the proposed constitutional amendment so that people know in advance what they're voting for and don't feel like they have to get there and be surprised.
Right. And if they want to call our office, we are available until from 8:30 to 5, and our number is 727-6218.
Okay. So. Well, it sounds like you're making voting as easy and accessible as possible, so as many of our Hampton residents who want to vote should be able to vote.
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely.
Okay. All right. Thanks, Tara. Thank you
for having me.
And thank you for watching. I hope you have learned a little bit, and remember to take that photo ID to the polls when you go to vote this year. Thanks for watching.